Good morning once again all of you. Welcome to the online classes of TMPS. Today we'll be continuing with the topic of longitudes. You know that in the previous topic we have discussed about the latitudes. Now we'll be continuing with the topic of latitudes and longitudes, and today we'll be discussing about longitudes. What are longitudes? Longitudes are basically the lines which are running from north to south. I have told you that the latitudes are the lines which are running from east to west, correct? In the same manner, longitudes are the lines which are running from north to south. There are total of 360 longitudes. There are total of 360 longitudes. 360 longitudes, how they are 360? 180 on each hemisphere. 180 on eastern hemisphere and 180 on western hemisphere. Now, you know that longitudes are 360, but the latitudes were 180. Very good. How latitudes were 180? 90 on northern hemisphere and 90 on southern hemisphere. Okay? Now, longitudes are very important because they tell us the time of a particular place. You know that if the longitudes would not be there, then the time of a particular place cannot be determined. The time of a particular place, the question which arises in your 9th board examination is find out the time of a particular place given a situation. So that can only be ascertained, they can be only find out with the help of longitudes. Now, longitudes along with latitudes are very important as they help in determining the exact location of a particular place. If you want to find out location of a particular place, then longitudes and latitudes are the best judge. If longitudes and latitudes both of them combine together, then you can find out the exact position of a particular place. Let us discuss how. So, how to find out exact location? How can you find out the exact location? I have told you many times, you must have heard that if we say that if we have to come to Allahabad, suppose it is not exact, but I am supposing. Suppose Allahabad is in around, you can say, suppose 30 degree north. Not to be precise, just the assumption. Let us take an assumption. Allahabad is 30 degree north. So can you reach Allahabad on 30 degree north? Because 30 degree north latitude, it is a latitude line, correct? It is a latitude line. Can you reach to Allahabad with only 30 degree north? Because 30 degree north would be from suppose this place to this place whole. It is not exact 30, we cannot tell that it is on the eastern hemisphere, western hemisphere, where it is. So, it is necessary that I should also tell you the longitude. Suppose I say that it is around 82.5 degrees. 82.5 degrees longitude. And that too in east. Now what would happen? You will be exactly reaching a particular point. Suppose I say that you reached this point. Suppose you reached this point. So, when you reach this point, you are in Allahabad. So, latitudes along with longitudes together are helpful to find out the exact location of a particular place. Now, I have told you that longitudes are very important to find out time. Now, what happens when you are talking about the longitudes? When you talked about latitudes, in latitudes what you have heard, that latitudes were the lines which were known as circles, correct? Great circle. Then I told you when you move towards the pole, the circle size decreases. In the same manner, longitudes are known with the name of meridians. Longitudes are known with the name of meridians. Very good. Meridians. Now the 0 degree meridian is known as prime meridian. 0 degree meridian is known as prime meridian. So 0 degree meridian or prime meridian basically is passing from a place which is in Greenwich. It is a place in Greenwich which is near London. It is near London, UK. And that is the place from where the time of different places of the world is divided. And there are different time zones in the world. These time zones are basically divided at an interval of 15 degree of longitudes. Very good. 15 degree of longitudes. I'll be telling how it is being divided. First of all, let us see what is the difference between a local time and a standard time. Okay. Then we'll be talking about further. What is the difference between a local time and a standard time? Local time. A local time is a time that is basically being ascertained or find out with the position of the sun overhead. Suppose हम अगर बात करते हैं तो सूरज की रोशनी होती है, sun is there. तो सन जितना हमारे सर के ऊपर है, जितना हमारे वेस्ट और ईस्ट में जा रहा है, उस हिसाब से वी डिसाइड द लोकल टाइम. बट व्हाट इज अ स्टैंडर्ड टाइम? मेनी मेनी टाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन इट इज 12 o'clock, सन पूरा ओवर है नहीं होता, थोड़ा बचा होता है या थोड़ा निकल गया होता है. तो व्हाट इज अ स्टैंडर्ड टाइम? अ स्टैंडर्ड टाइम इज बेसिकली अ टाइम व्हिच इज बीइंग केप्ट इन माइंड टेकिंग द ग्रीनविच टाइम इनटू कंसीडरेशन. That standard time is very important as it is being used in all the places of the world at the same time to avoid confusion. So remember that standard time is very important as it is being ascertained universally in the same manner by the help of GMT, that is Greenwich Mean Time, and that is very important for transactions all over the world, and local time is only for a particular period of place or particular place. Now, I hope this much is clear to you. Now, we'll be moving to the portion that how many time zones are there. So, how many time zones are there? I have told you, let us understand in such a manner that it is easy also and you can understand. There are 24 hours in a day. I am right. Correct. Okay, thank you. I am right. So, 24 hours are there in a day. How many minutes are there? 24 into 60. Since 1 hour is equals to 60 minutes. I hope this much is clear. So, 24 into 60, this is the number of minutes. And number of longitudes. How many longitudes were there? I have told you. 360, correct? 180 on each side, 360 longitudes were there. So, 1 degree longitude is equals to 24 into 60 upon 360. 0, 0 cancel, 1 cancel, this is 6, this is 1, this is 4. This means that 1 degree of longitude is equals to 4 minutes. I hope this much is clear. 1 degree of longitude is equals to 4 minutes. Correct? Now, this much is clear. Please go through this very important content because you should remember this. 1 degree longitude is always equals to 4 minutes. So, when you travel 100 degree longitude, how many minutes would be added? 400 minutes. Okay? Now, how many time zones are there? Please copy it down. You can pause the video and copy it down. Now, how many time zones are there? When you are talking about a time zone basically number of time zones. It can be found out there are 360 longitudes. And I have told you that a gap of 1 hour is there in between each time zone. 1 hour gap is there, so it would be 4 into 15, which is 60 minutes divided by 60, 1 hour. Correct? So, when you will be dividing it by 15, you will be getting 24. So, how many time zones are there? 24 time zones are there in the world. 12 of which lie in the eastern hemisphere and 12 lie in the western hemisphere. I hope this much is clear to you. This is a very important topic you should understand. Next, a very important topic, how to find out time of a particular place. You should remember this is a very important topic because you have questions from. Now, how to find out time. Remember, when you move towards east, time is added. This is a very important phenomena. Please learn that. Note it down and learn. Next, when you move towards west, time is deducted. Okay, time is deducted. Yahan simple yaad rakhiye, time is added, time is reduced. How I am going from east and west? When we are at 0 degree, when we are at 0 degree GMT, this is our position. When we will be moving towards the east, time would be added. When we will be moving towards the west, time would be deducted. This is the basic thing you should remember. In the next video, I will be telling you with some numericals to how to find out the time. Next, a very important question, that is the last question of this chapter, that why international dateline is a zigzag line? International dateline is a zigzag line because if the dateline would have been same, it would have been having same date in two different places. That is why it is at 180 degree east and west. It coincides with each other. 180 degree east and west coincides with each other. So what happens when it is coinciding and same line straight would be there, then what would happen? Same two places would have same date, same time, which are of different continents and different places. So to avoid that confusion, that time and date should not repeat. That is why that is a zigzag line. That is why it is known as ideal international date line is a zigzag line. I hope this much is clear to you. Please go through the concept once again. In the next video, we'll be discussing with the numericals that how to solve the question which comes on time. Thank you.